Hi, my name is Nick with Load Cell Central, and today we will be taking a look at the DSC-USB signal conditioner. The DSC-USB is a USB-powered signal conditioner capable of powering and monitoring up to 4 350-ohm load cells for data analysis. The DSC-USB provides 5 volts excitation and has a factory-adjustable sensitivity for use with virtually any strain gauge load cell. It is configured with its DSC Toolkit software, which allows for calibration, unit conversions, real-time graphs, overload settings, weight value format, and the ability to save and load DSC files for use with multiple load cells. It can also be utilized with its DSC Log24 software. This software allows multiple channels to view several DSC units, sum the values, and log data to an Excel spreadsheet. The load cell connection is made via a DB9 connector. Further connection to the computer is made via a micro USB cable. Once drivers and software have been installed, we can begin configuring our DSC USB. The first program used with the DSC USB is the DSC Toolkit. The home screen allows us to modify any of the connected modules. The Advanced Calibration screen allows us to perform a live calibration. Here we can select the first point used, which would be 0 pounds, and the second point used, which will be 10 pounds. You can see in the top right my load cell is not loaded, so we can acquire the 0 point. I now have 2 5-pound weights. Once loaded, we can acquire the second point, and our load cell is now calibrated. In addition to the live calibration, we can also perform table calibrations with millivolt per volt values, perform temperature compensations, and linearizations. The screen also provides limits for under and overload, units, and passcode protection. The basic calibration screen provides another conversion to another unit. We could do this with a live calibration, a table calibration, or we can use what's called simple unit conversion. Currently we're in pounds, so we can use any other force in this list. Kilograms, newtons, meganewtons, dynes, grams force, anything like this. Let's try kilograms. Now if I add 1 5-pound weight, this is about 2.2 kilograms. And the second weight, 10 pounds, is about 4.54 kilograms. Also available in this screen is a custom units section where we can specify any unit we'd like. We could do something like parts counting. So I'm gonna go ahead and use weights, and then perform a table calibration stating that 0 pounds equals 0 weights and 5 pounds equals 1 weight. Calibrate. Now if I format this to whole numbers, we'll be able to see that when I add 1 weight, it'll tell me that I have 1 weight. 2 weights equals 2 weights. We could do this with anything like jugs, tubs, bags, things like that. Could also do something like this with gallons. This screen also provides a shunt calibration, a system zero screen, as well as another set of limits for under and overload. The data rates and filter screen allows us to change the measurement rate as well as the filter settings. The logging screen allows us to log to a CSV file, which can be opened in Microsoft Excel. And the trend chart gives us a real-time chart that auto-scales based on the lowest and highest values the load cell has seen. So if I put pressure on this cell, we can see the chart will auto-scale with the lowest and highest readings. This is the Save Restore tab. Once a modification has been made, we can save our files here and restore them at a later date if we run into problems. The information screen provides a digital display of the calibrated value. This value can be teared using the gross net buttons, and the format can be changed. The screen will also show us our under and overload limits. Once we have configured our DSC USB modules, we can begin using the DSC Log24. This software consists of channels which make up the workspace. This workspace can be modified to include certain channels, some specific channels, or execute any of the other available commands. In my example, I'm using a 4-cell system, cell 1, 2, 3, and 4. I have cell 1, 2, 3, and 4. I also have the total or the sum of these cells. We take a look at the workspace. We can see each cell, 1, 2, 3, and 4, the channel number. These are specified by the serial numbers of the DSC USB modules. Channel 5 is using the sum command to sum all of the other channels. We can also change the format, the tear value, as well as whatever we would like to call that channel. So as you can see, if I place a 5-pound weight on the scale, I've placed it over cell 1. So cell 1 is reading about 4.71 pounds, but the total will read 5 pounds. I can move this anywhere on the scale, and the total should remain at 5. So we've got 5 pounds, 10 pounds, 15 pounds, 20 pounds, 25 pounds, 30 pounds, 35 pounds, 40 pounds, and 45 pounds. In addition to the workspace, the Log24 also features logging. We come here to the logging tab, we can begin logging. It will ask us to save our file. We're going to save it to the desktop as today's date. Once you save this, it will begin logging. So we'll go ahead and zero this out. We'll put a few weights on the scale just so we have some data. Once we're finished testing, we can stop logging. Now, if we return to this tab and click View Last Log, this will open our file in Microsoft Excel. You can see here, this will give us the date, February 18th, time, the elapsed milliseconds, each cell's output, as well as the total. So we had 5 pounds, 10 pounds, 20 pounds, then back down to 10, 5, and 0. This is just one of the ways to use the DSC Log24 software. For more information, please contact our sales team via phone or email.